First Lady Margaret Kenyatta today officially opened the inaugural Diplomats Photo Exhibition, dubbed Kenya Through the Diplomats Lens, at the National Museums of Kenya, Nairobi. The First Lady said the unique event showcases the prestigious collection of photographs illustrating Kenya's beauty and diversity.
This unique event showcases a prestigious collection of photographs illustrating Kenya's beauty and diversity through the eyes of the diplomatic corps in Kenya. I thank the participating missions who have shared their images that tell your various experiences in our wonderful country. We're also here to appreciate the remarkable talents of our youth who have participated by showcasing their creative work through images presented at this event. The idea of this storytelling initiative was conceived by a career diplomat who's an avid photographer, and today it has become a hybrid project involving a host of different partners, including the diplomatic corps, the private sector, the youth, and the community at large. This exhibition celebrates our country's diversity and also provides appreciation of culture, heritage, and harmony through photographs. As a result of its empowerment and mentorship projects, it will have great social impact that will inspire and nurture the talents of our youth in photo art. I've been told of the passion of the children from the Nikon Photo School in Kibera, who through this powerful tool can communicate their thoughts, inspire imagination, and build successful careers in photography. We must encourage our youth to pursue the arts and culture as a new frontier towards economic development for the future. The funds raised from this exhibition will support community-based organizations, including Destiny's Children's Center and Karika Caregiving Center for the Elderly. I greatly encourage these efforts that seek to bring social change for the good of different communities. Ladies and gentlemen, as we celebrate the profound power of art, let us appreciate the refreshing lens that photography provides us. It celebrates different aspects of our country and also reminds us of our responsibility to pay attention to the environment. Land, air, and water are all central to our survival. We must be deliberate in our actions to protect and preserve it for future generations. We're all custodians of this planet. I congratulate all of you who have put this initiative together and thank all the participants for sharing their work. And I now declare the Kenya Through the Diplomatic's Lens initiative officially launched and the photography exhibition officially open. I wish you all an enjoyable evening. Thank you.
This exhibition is geared towards the celebration of our country's beauty, manifest in its flora and fauna, and of course, we, its people. It also promotes the presentation of our cultural and national heritage by providing an opportunity for all of us to appreciate the photography on display while also raising funds for a noble cause. Ladies and gentlemen, it's said that taking an image, freezing a moment, reveals how rich reality truly is. I'll also quote Annie Leibovitz, the celebrated American photographer, who said the following: "The camera makes you forget you're there. It's not like you're hiding. You're just seeing so much." End of quote. I'm sure that our distinguished artists who provided the photographs that we are going to enjoy would agree with that. Your Excellency, today's event might be a new watermark in the recognition of photography as an art in our country. And we will collectively work to see the expansion of this space as a source of livelihood for many. In Kenya, like in many parts of the world, the cultural and creative sector is increasingly being recognized as an engine that can fuel job creation, innovation, contribute towards social cohesion, and trigger spillover effects that benefit the wider economy. This is true locally in many of our galleries in Nairobi and elsewhere. We as a government, Your Excellency, remain firmly on our commitment to support the cultural and creative industries. Our constitution in Article 11(2)A obliges our government to promote all forms of national and cultural expressions through literature, the arts, traditional celebrations, information, mass media, and other forms of cultural heritage. In order to actualize this commitment, the Sports, Arts, and Social Development Fund was recently established by His Excellency, the President of this Republic. That fund has helped support a lot of the work that's being done by our artists, our sportsmen, as well as our social development, and in particular and specifically the universal healthcare agenda. Your Excellency, today, however, we're here to celebrate the envoys that we host in our beloved country, who have taken time to look at us, decide how they actually want to portray us, and I think that will be very, very interesting for all of us to see. And I just want to tell them that we're really grateful. We're grateful for your generosity and for your creativity. We feel truly honored that you took your time to do this amazing, amazing work.
We are very grateful as an institution that the diplomatic corps in this country saw it fit to do the first inaugural photo exhibition at this museum. We were started in 1910, so this year we are 109 years old. And I want to invite all of you to come next year as we celebrate 110 years old. We were not like this when we started in 1910. Most of what you see now is through a refurbishment that was funded by the generous grant from the European Union citizens, which was done in the last 15 years or so, and I'm sure you can see the Kenyan people have tried to take care of this space that was renovated by European Union citizens. In this collection, we have 10 million specimens of artifacts that include fossils, cultural artifacts, biodiversity collections that is in our collection. So what you may be able to see today is only a quarter of what we have in our vaults. And that's why the government of Kenya, through the National Museums of Kenya Board, is now thinking of putting up two new legacy projects. One of them is the first natural history museum in the continent. We are planning that. And the second project that we're working on, and we hope that Our Excellency can be part of this, is the first art gallery of the of Kenya. Because we have a lot of collections that in this country, including some of the photos that you see today, that we would want to go to this gallery.
Your passion for the arts and preservation of the nature and cultural heritage of Kenya and its people is well known. And so I am sure you will appreciate the beauty and the diversity captured in the photographs on display, which have been taken by the diplomat community, having had the privilege living and working in Kenya. Your Excellency, anywhere you go, you will find there is usually a certain stereotype associated with diplomats and the diplomatic lifestyle. And it is my wish and my hope that the exhibition will be a platform through which the diplomatic community may play a part in advancing a positive image of the host country and promote closer cultural relations and bridging the gap with the local community. You have received numerous awards and accolades as a result of your kindness, generosity, and humility, helping those in need. However, it should not be the sole responsibility of the government to mobilize resources to help the needy. But all citizens and residents of Kenya in a position to help should rise to the occasion and extend a helping hand to the underprivileged society.
Reporting for Kenya Digital News from National Museums of Kenya, Nairobi, I'm Erastus Zomo.